Chick-fil-A. CEO Dan Caffey has been in the news a lot lately over his recent remarks against same-sex marriage. But it's his personal wealth and political contributions that make headlines tonight. Dan Caffey and Executive Vice President Donald Caffey have joined the ranks of the world's richest, according to financial research firm Privco. Out front tonight, Matt Miller, editor of Bloomberg Billionaires, a man who tracks this and knows everything there is to know about these guys who suddenly have emerged on the national stage as important power players. So how much are Dan and Donald worth?
They're each worth $1.5 billion. They own Chick-fil-A with their father, Truett Caffey, who founded the company decades ago and essentially invented the chicken sandwich. They split it three ways.
$4.5 billion company. Internet? You get to
invent the chicken sandwich. I mean, in the South, very much so. Chick-fil-A is sort of a staple in life in terms of their chicken sandwich and a big deal in the South.
All right, $1.5 billion for each of these guys. How unusual is that? When you look at other fast food chains, mm-hmm. McDonald's, et cetera, I mean, are these the richest of the rich, or is that sort of standard operating procedure?
It's not standard. They're some of the richest people in fast food, that's for sure. Mm-hmm. The richest people in fast food actually are the three Brazilian billionaires who were able to take Burger King public recently. Uh-huh. But this is certainly the richest family in fast food. At $4.5 billion.
And why haven't we heard of them before this? I mean, it sounds like they've been active in causes.
Well, they certainly have. I think it's a hot-button issue, and I think they haven't really given a tremendous amount of money to this, but it's such a hot-button issue at this point in this time, same-sex marriage. And people who are anti-same-sex marriage, you can get a lot of advocacy groups to talk about it and get upset about it, and you get people boycotting chicken sandwich shops. And we're talking about it right now. And so,
I guess that's true. But when Dan Caffey was the one who took the position on same-sex marriage in the radio interview, he said the company guilty as charged for backing the quote-unquote biblical definition of marriage. So I know you've taken time to look into how much money they're giving away and other, you know, I mean, is this like another Koch brothers sort of a family in terms of conservative causes?
It certainly is in terms of, if you look at, they have something called WinShape, which is the family foundation. And Chick-fil-A gives millions of dollars to WinShape. They have assets in 2010 of about $62, $63 million. They gave away $4 million in 2010. A lot of the groups that they gave to, $4 million, were to pro-family, pro-marriage, pro-foundations, that kind of thing. But if you look at it in terms of scale, Warren Buffett gave $2.8 billion or something like that to the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation last week or a couple weeks ago in terms of Berkshire Hathaway stock.
Right.
When you look at the percentage of their net worth, it's less than a tenth of a percent that they're giving away from the foundation. And so it's not, in terms of scale and billionaire giving, it's not this astronomical number.
Right, right. So it's not as I mean, but certainly people like Mitt Romney are giving away vast amounts of their wealth. It's a small percent.
In terms of dollar figures, it's a small figure. In billionaire terms, and it's also from a percentage of net worth. It's not the most ginormous number out there. If you look at Sheldon Adelson, the casino mogul, gave more away than they did just to Mitt Romney and Newt Gingrich in the past 6 months.